What's up, good people? Antonio Patterson Pre-Med here, and I am here today with another update on my academic progress. So I'm going to try to make this video as short as possible for those of you who are watching for the first time. I am Antonio Patterson. I'm a 47-year-old pre-med student currently in a master's degree program, biomedical science, with an emphasis on research. And this is actually the last week of this semester, or this school year, I should say. And so this is kind of an update. I have 2 days until the final comp exam. And so this is how everything's kind of going. So first of all, I want to say thank you guys again for following my journey. Thank you guys for your support. Thank you for your comments and all the love that you give me, inspiring me to continue to go forward. And I hope that I make you guys proud. Even more so, I hope that I inspire some people who are wanting to become physicians, or maybe not just physicians, you're wanting to make a change in life and you're at a later stage in life and you're not, you know, you're not going that traditional route, that it's okay, that everybody has a different path. You just have to have the desire and, you know, the fortitude to go after it. And so I am 47 years old. I will be 48 in 6 weeks. Craziness. But so I'm finishing up this last semester for this semester of the program. For those of you who follow me, you know that I am retaking a class from last semester. And although I passed 4 or 5 out of 6 classes last semester, the one class that you had to pass to move forward, I did not pass. And I missed that cutoff by less than a point. So 69.44, you need a 70 to pass. So I ended up going back this semester to retake that class from next semester. And of course, that put me a semester behind. So I still have another semester in this program, which I will finish this fall. So September, I'll be doing the second part of the program. And then, of course, I won't be able to start medical school until the fall of 2022. But you know what? That's okay. I'm cool with that. So to kind of put this in perspective, so this time last semester, going into the final exam, I had a 70 on the dot, 70.0. And I knew I had to make at least a 70 or higher in order to move forward. And so I have, this is my actual score report from last semester. And I'll just show you what I got. 69.44. So pretty devastating there. But here's the thing. And I know this is not medical school, but all this is medical information. Who wants a physician who only knows 70% of the information? And or at least that's the way I see it. Now, I know this is just a preliminary to get you to medical school. And most people think, well, I mean, if you pass, you pass. But you want to do better than just pass. You want to do more than just get by. And so I was not dismissed from the program. It did mess my GPA up really, really bad because there are no D's. You know, below 70 is failing. So I failed that class by 0.56%. Turn that around now to this semester, have a 91.9%. And I'm fighting to hold on to a A. Does that, I mean, that, what a turnaround from last semester. Fighting barely to pass, and now I really want this A. So I have a 91.9. So if we round that to 92, the lowest I can get on this final exam is a, I guess, 88. I have to have an 88 to maintain a 90, which will keep me at an A. And I tell you, I've been fighting for every inch of it, every inch. I just met with my academic advisor or counselor, and I looked over my last quiz that I got a 90, and I was so disappointed because, you know, you get to see what you missed. The two questions that I missed, so there's 20 questions on the quiz. The two that I missed, I had the right answer and I second-guessed myself and I changed both of them to wrong answers. So that would have given me a little bit more cushion, you know, instead of a 91.9, it was like a 92.1. But I mean, it is what it is. So I said all that to say, you can get better. I'm getting older, but I'm getting better. I'm learning how to learn. And believe me, all of these classes, pretty much they're video. I mean, they're recorded lectures. So when you're in medical school, you actually have a lecture, but all the lectures are recorded. You're not actually required to be there. You can be in your dorm room, wherever you want, and watch the lectures. It's the same information. So in our program, there's not dedicated master's lectures. All of these lectures are pre-recorded from the actual medical school lectures. So you're pretty much self-taught. They don't teach you. They tell you what you need to know. They tell you what you need to learn. And then you go learn it. And so for me, it's been for every lecture, which there can be anywhere from 8 to 11 hours of lecture per week. For every lecture, it takes 3 to 4 hours to make notes, go over it, digest that information. So if you have 11 hours of a lecture in a week, that could be 44 hours easily just of watching the lecture, making your notes, and then reviewing that lecture. And then for me, I spend about another hour making note cards, Anki note cards, which I talked about in a previous video. So 11 hours can turn to 55 hours. That's just preparing. That's not studying. That's preparing to study, putting the information in the format that you can digest it and learn it. And at 47 years old, I'm still doing it. I wish I had done it last semester. I'd be a little bit further along than I am right now, but I mean, it's okay. So that's where I am, guys. Next semester, I'll be taking Foundations of Medical Science Part 2 and Clinical Inquiry Part 2, which I'm really excited. The medical foundations, it's the foundations of medicine, and it's a very, very tough course. There's a lot of information, comes at you very quickly, a lot of memorization, and I don't know if I can, I'm going to try to put this behind me on the floor here, so that's what I'm studying now. Those are stacks of notes for the next comp. So I've been studying for the comp for the last probably 3 weeks now. So I'm pretty much finished studying and just kind of reviewing. But you can never be too sure that you know everything. And you pretty much have to know everything. But I feel a whole lot better about myself knowing 91.9 or almost 92% of the information and not just 70 and barely holding on. And to be honest, I think even with the 70%, I guessed a lot. But I know that this semester, I know 90% of this information. I'm confident that I have a 90. I'm a whole lot more confident in my studying. I'm a whole lot more confident in reading test questions and kind of figuring out what the question is asking, because they do give you a lot of information that you don't need. You do have to weed through a lot of information to get to the point of the question. So a lot more confident in that. So, but I did have the benefit. Now, I would say this, I did have the benefit of redoing a whole semester. So I was already exposed to that information. Next semester is a whole new bag, as they say, and a whole new bag of information that I haven't been exposed to yet, or maybe not in the depth that it will be for medical school, because I do have a master's in biomedical science, but it was not research oriented, and it was more of a pure master's degree program. It was not, the intention of the program was not to get the students into medical school per se. This program is to test you to see if you are capable of doing medical school level work. And so that's a difference. The intensity is a whole lot different. I could, with the degree that I have, I could go and teach biochemistry, or I could teach medical biology, or I could do that with that degree, but this program has been way more intense than the previous one. So guys, I'm doing the thing, as they say. I'm doing my best. I'm putting in work, 16 hours a day, pretty much 16 hours a day studying, sitting in this chair at this desk in front of this computer, since September, and then doing one of the classes twice. I've been putting in work, and I don't take anything from myself because I failed. I'm glad to have had the opportunity to fail, because I got in this program off the waiting list. There were 7,500 applicants, and I think they may have interviewed 10%. So I was in the 10% that even got interviewed. So I'm, very, what's the word? Grateful, I guess, to have even been considered. And then out of that waiting list, there are only 12 of us that got into this program. And so I'm very grateful. So, hey guys, I'm doing it. And I make this video to say you can do it too. And there's some of you guys out there who are younger than me. You're 32 and you're calling yourself old. You're 35, you're 37, you're 40. I'm getting close to 50. 50 is like right over there. 40 is way back there in the rearview mirror. So and people say sometimes, if I can do it, you can do it too. And I know that's easier said than done, because everybody's different. But I just feel like, I'm not going to say everybody can. That's not just not true. But a lot of people can, and you may be one of the ones. I mean, you get to make that evaluation and determination. But what I am saying is, you owe it to yourself to try. You owe it to yourself not to sit there living a life of misery, doing something that you don't like, being comfortable, because you were a C student. I was a C student. Coming out of undergrad, I had a 2.8, and that was adjusted after I took some classes over. What that means is that I was a BC student, and I made a few more B's than C's, And so to be in a graduate program where I took six classes and I got five A's, even though I flunked one, for me, that's just a big deal. And if I get an A in this class and I get to replace that failing grade, that means I will have been a straight A student for the first time in my life at 47 years old. That's nuts. That's just nuts. And I feel like I'm getting better. So you owe it to yourself. I know this video is getting long. I try to keep it less than 15 minutes, and I'm at like 13 right now. So I just want to say, you owe it to yourself. And not only that, I mean, you owe it to the people around you. I mean, if there's greatness inside of you and you die with that, you will have failed the people around you, who need to see your success as a launching pad for their own success. So I'm telling you, go to your local junior college, go to your community college, go to your pre-med advisor, find somebody and start asking questions. What do I need to do to get to where I know I need to be? And so I'm going to leave you guys with that. Thanks again. By the way, we're almost up to 500 followers. Isn't that crazy? Or I guess it's subscribers now, but almost 500. That's just great. So if you watch this video and you have not subscribed, I want you to go right now, right now, right now. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button. I guess it's at the bottom there. And show me some love in the comments. Look, guys, I got two more days to study for this final comprehensive exam. I'm rocking it. Thank you guys for following me. As soon as I get my score back, I'm going to let you guys know what is up. Tonio Patterson, pre-med. Peace out.